Following the assassination of former Japanese Prime Minister Abe Shinzo, the armed forces of the Philippines assured Filipinos former and current leaders of the country are well protected. The AFP says the presidential and vice presidential security groups are in full force to ensure the safety of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and Vice President Sara Duterte Carpio. Additional security personnel are also deployed in places that both leaders will visit.
Meanwhile, President Marcos's condition continues to improve after testing positive for COVID last Friday. His doctor says the president only had mild COVID-19 symptoms over the weekend. No fever, no loss of taste or sense of smell. Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles said his lead physician, Dr. Samuel Zacate, visited Marcos on Saturday and noted that the president's throat was clear of any inflammation. There was also no sign of respiratory distress or pneumonia. Marcos continues to work in isolation, giving out directives to his cabinet officials in the comfort of his home. This is the second time that Marcos tested positive for the coronavirus. The first was during the height of the pandemic in 2020.
Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Boying Remulla, also recovering from COVID-19. Remulla tested positive for the virus Thursday last week, prompting him to beg off from a meet-and-greet session with reporters covering the Justice Beat that was originally scheduled today. On Sunday afternoon, Remulla tweeted that he was feeling well enough to go back to work, but says he is still required to finish his 7-day quarantine. He will continue to work from home until Wednesday. President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. open to making the wearing of face masks optional when it is already safe to do so. But in order to get to that stage, Marcos emphasized the importance of ramping up the country's COVID-19 booster uptake, especially for children, as his administration plans to fully allow the resumption of in-person classes this year. He's looking at local officials to lead the charge in strengthening their respective booster campaigns.
Gawin natin itong booster rollout at makakatiyak tayo. Wala nang lockdown. At ayaw na namin magkaroon ng lockdown. At pagka maging matagumpay ang ating booster rollout, ay makikita naman natin, siguro pwede na nating ibaba ang mga alert level, pwede na natin gawing optional ang mask. Pero hindi po natin gagawin yan hanggang maliwanag na safe na talaga.
The League of Provinces of the Philippines ready to heed the call of President Marcos to strengthen the rollout of boosters in the country. The group's president, Marinduque Governor Presbytero Velasco Jr. says they are already looking at possible ways to encourage their constituents to get the additional COVID vaccine doses.
Iinganyohin natin yung ating mga rural health units at ang ating mga doktor na talagang pagpalakasin yung pagbigay ng booster shots at nagbibigay na nga kami ng incentives at alam namin importante itong booster shot. Palalakasin namin ito sa mga provincial governments.
Based on the Health Department's vaccination dashboard as of Saturday, only 15.2 million Filipinos have received the COVID-19 booster shot out of the more than 70.8 million individuals eligible for it. The combined effects of the southwest monsoon in a low-pressure area seem to bring rainy weather across the country this week. Let's get more details from Pagasa weather forecaster Obet Badrina. Obet, what do you have for us? Good morning.
Good morning, especially to all our televiewers. So here's the latest about regarding our weather. As of 3 a.m., the low-pressure area that we're monitoring is located now at 635 kilometers east of Infanta in the province of Quezon. So because of this low-pressure area, areas in eastern Visayas, Dinagat Islands, Surigao provinces, Bicol region can still expect a generally cloudy skies now with some scattered rain showers and thunderstorms. Meanwhile, other parts of the country, particularly in the western side of Luzon and Visayas, these are the areas of western, including the central Visayas, Imaropa, as well as some areas in northern Mindanao and Zamboanga Peninsula can still expect cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms. This is due to the southwest monsoon or hanging habagat. Here in Metro Manila and other remaining parts of our country, we can still expect a generally fair weather in the morning, but expect also the occurrences of rain showers and thunderstorms in the afternoon and in the evening. So these are caused by localized thunderstorms, which can last up to 1 to 2 hours. So regarding the low pressure area located east of Luzon, as of now, no, based on our latest data, there's still a slim chance or low probability or low possibility of development into a tropical depression, but we're still continuing monitoring the this particular weather system. So that's the latest in our weather from Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Center, Obet Badrina reporting.
All right, thanks for that update, Obet Badrina.